Hello everybody, I am Mr. Raz, SAP Basis International Trainer, train students in more than 50 countries. Punarvasi Technologies is my company. www.punarvasi.com is my website, where I use to write different step-by-step procedures of SAP Basis Administrator's daily tasks. Many people got benefited from my articles. In this video, I will show you how to schedule a job in background in an SAP system using start condition time dependent. So I have logged on to the SAP system already here. It is the SAP Easy Access screen. As soon as you log on to the SAP system, you will get this screen. This screen is called SAP Easy Access screen. To schedule job in background, we should have the background work processes in the system. So the number of background work processes can be defined. So the background work processes should be there. These are all the background work processes. And also, you should check the time dependent scheduler parameter. Means, at specific interval of time, the scheduler will run. Once you schedule the job, immediately the particular job will not run. So, the time should come. Means, the interval should pass. Then only the background work process, that is, background job will run. Okay. How to find out that particular parameter? So you can find out the value of the particular parameter using RZ11T code. The parameter name is RDISP/BTC type. Start interval for background scheduler. What is the time interval? 60 seconds. Means every 60 seconds, the scheduler will check for the background jobs to run. And the particular background job will run when there is a free background work process is available. So let us schedule a job. So to schedule a job, you need to go back to the Easy Access screen, enter SM36T code. SM36T code is for scheduling background jobs in SAP system. Hit enter. In the defined background job screen, this is called defined background job initial screen. As soon as you enter SM36T code, whatever the screen you will get, that is called initial screen of defined background job. You have to specify the job name here. The job name which I want to specify here is RDISP background job. Means I am going to run a program called RSPFPAR. If you have watched my earlier video, I have created a variant for a program RSPFPAR. So I will use that particular program in this particular background job. Means I'll specify the step using the above program of RSPFPAR. So that according to that program, I am naming this background job. The job name is RDISP busy job. Okay, and the job class is, means the priority of the job is C. There are three types of priorities are available. That is A, high priority, B, middle priority, C, low priority. If you have seen my video on fundamentals of background administration, I have explained about these three different priorities. So most of the jobs are priority with C. Okay, there is no need to change anything here. And first status is scheduled, and once the start condition is specified, that particular job can be released for the execution. And you can also specify the execution target. Means if you don't specify any execution target, whatever the available server is there, application server is there, that particular server will perform this particular job. If you specify the execution target, means whatever the target you specify here, that particular server only will perform this particular background job. But suppose if right now only one application server is available within this SAP system, so that either you select it or not, doesn't matter, because if you don't select, same server will perform. If you select also, same server will perform this particular job. So this is optional. You can double click on that particular server name, so that server name will be displayed here. Okay, so once you specify these details, you have to click on the save button. You have to click on the save button. So as of now, you have created a background job, you have defined a background job, but you have not specified any program to run in the background. Means you have to create the job step. It is called job step. You see, the background, whatever we have given the information, that is there, and one more screen is displayed here. This is separate screen, and this is create step one screen. Means first job step. Any number of job steps can be defined within the single job. Okay, and here I am going to run a program, ABAP program. So if you click on the ABAP program, you have to specify the details according to the ABAP program. If you want to run some external, so you have to provide the external command information in these boxes. So whatever you click, that particular section will be activated. So now to perform this particular experiment, I will use the ABAP program to run the ABAP program called RSPFPAR. If you remember that I have created a variant in my earlier video for this particular program, so that particular variant should be available here. Okay, so click on this button and click on the possible options button to choose the variant. So what is the variant we have created? RDISP_PARAS is the variant we have created in earlier video. Double click on that, so that this particular program will run with this particular variant. Means the background job will not ask you to input something while running the program. Means background job means what? Without user intervention, that particular job should run and it should finish, isn't it? So that you have to specify the variant for an ABAP program. Once you specify the variant, just click on the save button. You can also click on the check button, so that it will verify whether the variant is available or not. If the variant is not available and ABAP program is not available, you will get the error screen here. So because both are available in the system, so that it is not displayed any error, just directly you can click on the save button to save the job step. Once you click on the save button, the job step will be created. This is the job step. Step list overview. So first step is created. If you want to add another step in this particular job, again you can click on the create button to create another step. Means in that step you can specify a ABAP program or external command or external program. Okay, so once you created the step, just click on the go back button from here. Click on the go back button. Click on the go back button. Okay, job RDISP busy, job saved with status scheduled. And the job steps are one step successfully defined. One step is successfully defined. And the job is still scheduled. It is not released. The job can be released when you have, without specifying start condition, you can't release the job. You have to specify the start condition. So the information will come here. That is job start and job frequency. And when it should start and how frequent the particular job should run. Okay, you have to specify the start condition to release the job. To specify the start condition, you have to click on the start condition button from the application toolbar. Click on the start condition, and here another screen will be displayed. From this screen, you can specify different types of start conditions. What different types of start conditions? Immediate, data time, after job, after event, at operation mode. And actually this is time dependent scheduling of the job. So in the next video, I'll show you how to schedule a job with start condition after event, means event dependent scheduling of jobs. Okay, so now if you want to run this particular job immediately, you have to click on the immediate button. If you want to specify the date and time, you have to click on the date and time button. Okay, I am just clicking on the date and time to specify the date and time. Click on the date and time here. By clicking on the possible options button, that is 19th June 2014, and the time you can specify whatever the time is there. 11:41 means after. Okay, it is right now the 11:41:45. Just you make this 41 as 43. Okay, and once you specify the scheduled start time and date, you can directly click on the save button to save this particular start condition. And also you can specify the no start after, means if you specify the date and time here, that particular job will not start after this particular date and time. Okay, so click on the save button directly to specify the start condition. You see the specify the start condition is displayed here, that is date and time are displayed here. And job frequency, this job will not run, means it will not run again, only one time the job will run. So once you specify these details, click on the save button. So job RDisp busy job saved with status released. Now you see, the once you specify the start condition, the status is released. You can view the status of this job using SM37T code. Just go back from here, or you can open another session to view the information about jobs using SM37T code. So you can choose schedule all the options and click on the execute button so that the particular job will be displayed here. See which one, this one. So earlier the job is scheduled here and now the job is released here. The status of this particular job is released. Okay, click on the refresh button. So when it will start? 11:43 time. I have specified the time as 11:43, and the job scheduler should start, means the job scheduler, I have shown you the parameter, that is RDisp/BTC time. Every 60 seconds the job will, the whatever the jobs are scheduled, whatever the jobs are released, that will run. Okay, just the status is released and it is finished also. Finished, and you see the to run this particular job, the time duration took is 1 second and delay is 7 seconds, means the job scheduler starts every 60 seconds. As soon as it is released and as soon as it is started, the 7 seconds delay is there. Okay, so in this way you can schedule the time dependent jobs. Okay, and the status is finished. And if you want to see the result of this particular job, you select the job and click on the spool button from the application toolbar. It will give you the result of this particular job. Click on the spool. Okay, select the spool request and click on the display contents so that it will display all the contents. You see RDisp, the parameters which are all started with the RDisp is displayed here. So like this. So job is scheduled, released and finished, and it has given the output. So this is the process of scheduling time dependent background jobs. If you have any questions or doubts, you can leave your comments in my website www.punarvasi.com, or you can leave your comments under this video also. Thanks for watching.